My name is India. I'm from Huntington Station. This is my sister, Tanisha. I'm looking to connect with my deceased fiancé, Kendall, to hopefully get a little closure.
How are you?
I'm Teresa. Nice to meet you. Watch your step.
I feel like it's important for my sister to have this reading today. She likes to hold everything in, so to anybody that doesn't know her, you wouldn't even know anything is wrong. But I know everything's wrong.
So, I want you to look at this session as more of like an experience than a reading. The experience of feeling, sensing your loved ones. So I am going to start with the young male. Who is the young male that's departed?
That would be Kenny.
And who would that be?
That's my fiance.
My fiance, Kenny, he was very outgoing. If Kenny walks in a room, he's life of the party. He was like a social butterfly.
Would you call him KK or?
Kenny Cash.
Oh, cause I'm like, what's K? I'm like, what is that? What's KK? And he's like, you're not gonna get it. I'm like, I don't know what this is. So you used to call him what?
Kenny Cash.
Kenny Cash.
Wow.
He was flashy, had every pair of sneakers you could imagine. And had to match.
He talks about the night that he passed. Were they trying to say that it was like self-inflicted?
Wow. Yes, they did.
He says that's not true.
I know it's not true. I was there.
Because Teresa, they came from nowhere, like out of nowhere. And then the next thing I knew, he goes, I died. Does that make sense?
Yep.
Kenny had just gotten home from work. We were in our bedroom watching TV, and he was sitting like close by the window. And a gunshot came in through the window in the middle of our conversation. We both started running towards our front door. When he went back inside is when the second shot came through and it hit him.
Can you still hear yourself screaming when you found him?
Yep.
He says, I need you to stop reliving that night and feeling that if something was done differently, that he would still be here.
I was like yelling his name through the house and he would never respond. I went into our bedroom and that's when I saw him laying on the floor in his blood. I felt like my world was over.
What did you place inside the casket? Was it a rose?
Mm-hmm. When they pronounced him deceased, someone at the hospital had given me a flower. And I put it in his hand before they took him away. I gave him one at the hospital.
I was actually sitting outside of the hospital. This guy was coming out and he had flowers in his hand, and he just walked up to me and gave me one. And that same flower, I gave it to him. And I asked the nurse to make sure that rose never leave his hand.
So know that as that gentleman handed you that flower, that was Kenny's soul which got that gentleman to do that. And that was his way of saying farewell. I said to him, why did you have me say farewell, he says, because I never said goodbye. Never said goodbye.
He used to always say, never say goodbye, always say, see you later.
He made me feel like that was his gift to you of his saying goodbye.
I feel a sense of relief to know that he's okay, and I really needed the closure, I'll say that.
Did he always used to use the statement, you have my heart?
Yeah.
He says, you have my heart.
This reading with Teresa, I definitely needed to help start a healing process.
I wish you all the best of luck.
I know my sister needed this reading, just so she knows that he's around.
Thanks for coming with her.
It was an experience I'll never forget, that's for sure.
where have you been?
I mean, where have I been?
You're in big trouble.
What am I in big trouble about?
Because I dreamt last night that you were cheating on me.
Really?
Yeah. I dreamt that Larry was having an affair. And I'm like, are you kidding me? Seriously?
It's funny you mention that, because I had a dream that some girl was trying to hit on me.
See? I knew it. Maybe I was finishing your dream.
Yeah, I think you were.
I think what happened is you were dreaming it, and you got so flustered until, like, someone's interested in me besides my wife. You woke up, and then I finished out the dream. A load of hot water over here, and you're laughing?
Listen, I heard you guys from upstairs. Don't flatter yourselves. No one's trying to hit on either.
See, I told you.
I had a dream that your father was cheating on me. So you know how you're gonna make it up to me? You're gonna take me for dancing lessons. I wanna learn how to do the Lindy.
What is dancing lessons?
Yeah.
What, are you kidding me?
It's either
the horizontal mambo.
No, no, no. The Lindy lesson or marriage counseling. Pick your poison. Dance lessons is something that I've been wanting to do for a long time, and Larry has always said no.
Against my will, I will do the dancing lessons.
So now I got him by the gayoon, so we're going for dance lessons. That's not the Lindy.
This has got to be the stupidest thing ever.
I think you and Leah should join us.
No, I'm not doing the Lindy. That's like me learning Latin. It doesn't, like, it's so old, it doesn't make sense to do.
You live under my roof, and you're gonna come and learn the Lindy.
I just walked downstairs. I was in the wrong place at the wrong time. And now I gotta go dance and do the Lindy.
Spin your mother. Come on. Yeah, there you go. Hey.
It's like I live in a fun house. It's like it's a joke all day.
Uh-oh, this looks very professional. Tonight's the big dance lesson. My husband, my son, and his girlfriend, whether they like it or not, we're all cutting the rug. I'm Denise. Nice to meet you. I'm Teresa.
I really don't know why me and my girlfriend are taking this dance lesson with my parents, but somehow we got suckered into it.
So what brings everybody in tonight?
He's in trouble. This is why we're here.
Don't listen to him.
I had a dream that he was having an affair.
This whole dancing thing is ridiculous, but I do it just to make my wife happy.
I just feel a family that dances together stays together. I was tortured by the dream. He's gonna be tortured by this dance lesson.
First rule, men, you always start with your left foot. Ladies, you always start with your right.
When we first start this class, I'm feeling confident because I got a dancer's background.
Look at Larry. Who does he think he is?
When I danced at the clubs, I used to always have girls asking me to dance. I'll leave it at that.
I'm a very bad dancer, according to my husband. I'm really not that coordinated.
Oh, geez, see, this is where I'm at, but I'm not doing it.
If your partner's foot goes forward, your foot has to go back.
Oh, geez, see, I just stepped on his toe.
I couldn't tell you how many feet I ended up stepping on.
Uh-oh, sorry, I stepped on your foot.
I just really thought that I had really good eye, hands, and feet coordination. But after this dance lesson, not.
I have zero dancing experience, but I learned that I am shorter than most women in the world, or at least on Long Island.
I have to reach up, so.
I was like this with her.
We just look stupid now.
I know.
It just looked ridiculous.
I'm trying to wash my feet.
I didn't think I was doing so hot, so I took a look over at old Fred Astaire, and he was more like Left Foot Larry.
I can't get this right.
Yes, you
can. It's not easy.
I don't think his clubbing days were helping him out here in this old dance lesson.
You're doing the hustle, Larry.
Look, the bottom line is, whether I got the dance or not,
please, please come again, because we really enjoyed it. I hope you enjoyed it as well.
Yes, thank you. Woo! We had a lot of fun.
Well, we had a great time. It was so much fun. I felt just like Ginger. Call me Ginger Caputo.